What you see on the screen here is a flow called Push Limited, built by 3ds Max Ninja and living legend Martin Coven. Applied that to some geometry, and as you see, there's some kind of interaction there. What we're going to build today is just a traditional push, recreating one of the max modifiers in MCG, just to get an idea of how the data flows through the system. So here in Max, we have a torus shape, and we'll throw just a traditional push on there to see what it does. We're all familiar with this, pushes along the normals. So what would we do if we wanted to build this in MCG? We'd need some information about the mesh. We need some vertices and some normals. We'll do a little math and make a MCG modifier, and we'll recreate this. So to open MCG, or Max Creation Graphs as it's called, you open the scripting panel and you pop this open. With the Max Creation Graph open, I want to give a quick brief rundown of what some of these different components are in this UI here. So in the upper right here, you've kind of got this nav where you can move around, but on the left here, you have all your nodes, and there are some compounds in here as well. We'll get a little more into that in a sec. The bottom here is a description, so if you were to roll out one of these categories for nodes, like, parameters for instance, parameter single, a parameter of a non-compound graph of single type. So it gives you a little bit of information and a signature, which it can be handy. It's like a data signature, especially when information is flowing through a node. It's nice to know, hey, it wants this kind of data in, it's kicking this kind of data out. On the bottom right here is a message log. When you evaluate these tools, it'll either tell you that it successfully evaluated, and then it's going to be a tool you can use as a modifier or a utility or any number of things in Max. Or if it fails because something isn't hooked up right, it sends you some kind of cryptic explanation in computer speak. I believe this is being worked on to be a little more clear, but as it is now, it's better than nothing. It can give you an idea of at least where you're falling down. So that's kind of the basic idea of the UI. You know, you can open graphs, you can save graphs. Under build is evaluator, control E. Has a nice search feature where, you know, you could type in mesh, and these are all the nodes that start with mesh. If I do an asterisk first, these are all the nodes that just have mesh in their name. So this one starts with node, mesh, and local space. I won't pretend to know what all these different nodes are. There are hundreds of them, and I'm just scratching the surface and figuring them out. But what's cool is a lot of people in the community can start making and building up different nodes, and we can see what other people do and kind of reverse engineer from there. So briefly, to kind of give an idea of the hierarchy of what's going on here. So we have nodes. A node can do some math, it can change a data type, as in, for instance, this is a vertex normals node. It wants mesh information, and it's gonna kick out an array of normals. So vertex one normal is gonna be a vector, you know, three numbers of the direction that that vertex is pointing. And it'll make an array for every vertex in a piece of geometry. So a node is a low-level building block. If you have a combination of nodes, you can combine them into what is called a compound. So for example, and they're shown in this kind of purple-magenta color, so this is a compound called white. If we were to open up this compound and see what's happening inside of it, there is a vector 3, and float 1 is being piped into X, Y, and Z. So you can think of these as RGB as 111. You know, 000 would be black, 111 is white, and then that outputs white. So we see this output here, that would be just kicking out 111, a vector 111. You pipe it into color, it's going to give you white. There's no, you know, instead of this being just a constant float being piped in here, we also could put a parameter in there. And then those are the things that show up in the UI that you could actually, you know, plug in your own RGB values if you wanted to give the user control of that. So compound, bunch of nodes packed into a nice tight package here. It just keeps big graphs a little simpler to see. From a compound is a tool. This tool consists of, you can see there's some compounds here and there's just some nodes. And these ones with the brown here are parameters, where we're either bringing in geometry or we're allowing the user to input some information that then, you know, these become variables in this and control various aspects of your tool. So tools are kind of like a tool could be a modifier. You could put it on an object. These are really what you're going to be building up from nodes and compounds. And then to go one bigger is the packaged MCG graph. Once you build a tool and you want to share it, or you see a tool online that you want to download and play with, you can take this. I think of it as being a tool that's been zipped up, and all the components you need are all in that zip, so they all unpack. Because some user may be making compounds that you don't have, the package graph puts everything in one place, so it all unzips and you have everything you need. I think about it a little bit like in Max, if you save archive, saves all the dependencies in one place, or like an After Effects collect, saves everything you need, so it makes it a little easier to pass that on to people. So this is a blank slate. We know we're going to do a modifier, so we need to pull in a couple nodes here. Output modifier, that will dump the resulting information back into the stack, as well as we need an input. Modifier trimesh input, so that brings it in. So you get your input, your output, and the math happens here in between. So we know from our trimesh, we're gonna need the mesh vertices, so pull that in. And we need the normals. And what we want to do is run a function on these. Essentially, we want to multiply the vert position vectors by a parameter, and then we want to add that to the normals so that each one of those vertices moves outward along the normal. So we can bring in another parameter here that will be our push value. For this, we're going to do a parameter single, which is going to pump a float value into our flow here. So let's do a minimum of negative 100, max 100, default 0 is fine. And then from there, we want to do a multiply by scalar. So if we were to do this alone, to just multiply the mesh vertices by scalar, it essentially would scale about its origin. But then from here, we want to add the vertex normal vector, and that will then give us the push in the correct direction. So these two numbers here are going to pump out a function, and we will combine the mesh vertices and the mesh normals by this function. So essentially what this is doing is we're taking the scaled vertex position vector and we're adding the vertex normal vector, and adding the two gives the vector a direction, while scaling here gives it a magnitude. So this is going to push it, this is going to give a magnitude, this is the direction that it's flowing in. From this parallel combined, we can't just dump this right into the output modifier, so we need to set mesh vertices. This wants an input of that original trimesh. So it's saying, hey, I've got this mesh, and I'm going to dump out a new set of vertices that have been multiplied by this, added to the vertex normal. And then this combine node will transform the array by this function here. So we'll dump that trimesh back out into an output modifier. We can do a save as here. This MCG push. We then evaluate, and then it will show up in our modifier stack. So if I pull down the stack here, we should have something called MCG push. There it is. Sure enough, push in the positive, it pushes out, and if I push into the negative, it shrinks down. So as a quick overview of what we were doing in this flow, we start out with this modifier, brings in the trimesh, we get an array of vert position vectors, and we get an array of normal vectors with these two nodes here. From there, this argument of the array of mesh position vectors is passed down to this multiply by scalar, and we multiply vert position vectors by a parameter scalar. So if we just did this, if we would be scaling essentially the geometry about its origin. From there, we take an argument from the vertex normals and we add that to the multiply by scalar. So taking the scaled vertex position vector and adding the vertex normal vector gives us a direction in which to push those vertices. Both the mesh vertices and vertex normals that have been transformed by this function here are then dumped into this parallel combine, which is going to kick out a new array of the new positions of the vertices. Then we put a set mesh vertices node in there, which takes the trimesh that is passed in by the modifier and sets these vertices as defined by this array. That then dumps out a new mesh output modifier, then kicks it out, and you see it happen in your viewport. So that's just a quick demo of a basic max modifier that has been reproduced in MCG. There's a lot of potential to take these modifiers and extend them. Some of the samples I was showing early on with the limited push are some examples of that. And once I get my head wrapped around this a little more, I'd like to do a demo of it as well.